particular. And did you know that there is an island of non-existent geodata on Earth? This is actually a virtual place where each of us has really been. Today, you will find out how dangerous this place is, what this island consists of, and at the end of the video, you will see what you can find there. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. I promise to please you often with interesting new videos. And so, we put on swimming trunks and swimsuits, sailed to a virtual island. What is Null Island? In the very center of the Gulf of Guinea, you can see the intersection of two conditional lines, the equator and the international reference meridian. This is the very mysterious Zero Island. This point has coordinates 0 north latitude and 0 east longitude. In fact, there is nothing here but an ocean almost 5 kilometers deep and a weather boy codenamed Soul. Takawa is a location in our physical world, and the space itself is informational. In fact, you won't believe how many objects this place contains. Just imagine, there is an active economic activity here, even if you have been here at least once. Very strange. Although, you don't even remember it. Now I will explain everything in order. It so happened that these non-existent geodata became a problem for all mankind. Surely you've seen a map app, widget, or frame on a site that is centered by default on a point in the Atlantic Ocean off the coast of Africa. I am sure that you have definitely been there and visited Zero Island, and most likely more than once. Your digital identity left a mark on this place very simply by uploading in photos that do not have shooting coordinates. If the portal supports searching by the geolocation of an image, there is a high probability that such files will appear on the map in the Gulf of Guinea. Because database creators too often fail to handle missing data correctly and simply replace null with zero, this is how the name of the Zero Island was formed. Null Island. Back in 2008, Tableau analyst Steve Pellegrin first introduced this concept into the everyday life of geographic information system specialists. Since that time, Zero Island has gone through several stages of popularization, from an inside joke of employees of one of the company to an element of slang for IT specialists associated with geocoding, and then entered the public culture. At the same time, the importance of the virtual point is growing every year. So, it's time to look at Null Island from a scientific point of view. The first full-fledged work on this topic was done by Levente Juez of Florida International University and Peter Money of the Irish National University at Maynooth. The researchers analyzed a huge amount of open sources that mention Null Island, a point with coordinates of 0 degrees north latitude and 0 degrees east longitude, or other stubs of missing geodata. It was Juez and Monet who first assessed the contents of the Zero Island, showing what data could be found in these coordinates. Where not otherwise indicated, coordinates refer to the 1984 World Geodetic System of the Earth. It is the de facto standard for almost any modern application of geodata. In fact, your Null Island can be in any coordinate system. Just this one is the most common. When zero values of latitude and longitude fall on land, such a place is called Zero Lake. But how is the filling of the Zero Island going on? A geographic information system works with at least two types of data: coordinates in a given reference system and information associated with them. In order for the navigator to build a route at the request of the user, the program needs to know exactly where the address is at point A on the virtual ellipsoid, which is a simplified representation of our planet. And of course, to correlate, the current coordinates of the user with objects on the map in order to visualize the path and issue recommendations on the direction of movement. Similar data transformations are necessary for every application or online service that operates with geodata. Even if it's just a simple mapping resource, let alone navigation software, social media, and classified sites. The most important thing when working is a database where coordinates and other information are indicated in one line. But sometimes, the field with latitude and longitude is empty. For some reason, the surface did not receive them. Such a cell has a null parameter, which should ideally tell the script there is no data or it is not available. A very common mistake is to confuse zero with zero, and its correct operation causes a lot of problems for programmers. The main mystery is that the null label is not a number, text, reference, pointer, or any other commonly used data. The problem is the existence of two logical values, true or false. In order to work correctly with the third, modifications are needed. In the ideal case, the code working with the database should take into account such nuances and carry the tools for correctly responding to missing values. But anyone with even the slightest knowledge of IT knows perfectly well that well-executed programs have never been in the majority. They often use null conversions to the data type that corresponds to the requested cell. And when it comes to coordinates, it is 0 degrees north latitude and 0 degrees east longitude. These unintentional data processing errors are perhaps the most common reason for anything to end up on Zero Island. Such troubles may arise due to the inattention of programmers or lack of experience in working with geodata. Because of this, it is not uncommon for WGS 84 latitude and longitude values to be interpreted as parameters in the projection coordinate system. Problems with testing services, preparing and processing input information, all this also helps to replenish Null Island with content. However, there are other reasons. Sometimes, something ends up in the Gulf of Guinea on purpose. For example, coordinates 0 degrees, 0 degrees are set as default values in case of missing data or malfunction of satellite navigation equipment. Sometimes, the data is sent to the Zero Island or to mask the true location. The original purpose of Null Island in software is to become a container for information that does not have precise geodata associated with it. What do you think can be found at this point? Often, these are photographs, running routes, and training marks, and even accommodations for rent and restaurants with tourist attractions. Social networks with the function of linking content to geographic coordinates. All these services, despite the colossal staff of programmers, huge audience, and rich functionality, one way or another contain errors in their code, leading to the display of incorrect geospatial marks. But there are cases much more interesting. Some points of blockchain projects are also fixed on the Zero Island, that is, a cryptocurrency, the mining of which is carried out by maintaining the efficiency of the router. What is most amusing, since the correct geolocation of the registration access point is the basis for the functioning of the network, users have high confidence in the coordinates of infrastructure nodes. Therefore, when they saw several Chinese-owned routers right in the middle of the Gulf of Guinea, some especially impressionable individuals decided that the Celestial Empire had organized a secret military base in the Atlantic. The logic is fantastic, yes, but do not feed conspiracy theorists with bread. Let them discover a worldwide conspiracy. From flights to works of art, from coronavirus patients to real estate, all this can be found in the open database of the Zero Island. This is precisely what gives cause for serious concern. How serious and dangerous is all this? Null Island is a side effect of possible geolocation errors, wrong coordinates of something, and we get a clear danger of the Zero Island. Of course, not specifically this conditional place on the map, but the chain of events, actions, and decisions associated with it. In his earlier work, Monet addressed the problem of the colossal number of COVID-19 cases in the middle of the Gulf of Guinea. Of course, in reality, they were not there. It's just that Johns Hopkins University, creating its famous interactive coronavirus map, placed all the data on the Zero Island without a confirmed geolocation. A few months later, the practice was considered incorrect and the problem was eliminated. Information on which the location was late was simply entered later. The trouble is that such nominal data have to be thrown away and not considered reliable. But the trick is that you can't completely delete them either. Data with lost coordinates can contain a huge amount of useful information. The most obvious inconvenience of Null Island should not be underestimated. The display of some objects in the Gulf of Guinea instead of the real location. Sometimes this only leads to funny bugs in the interfaces, such as visualization of the flight of the displays in the cabin of an airliner when instead of New Orleans. The flight departs from the Zero Island and at another time to quite obvious fake news. As in the case of the Chinese base of the coast of Africa, things were more serious in 2012 in the US state of Wisconsin. After the introduction of new digital systems for registering the population and counting votes, it turned out that part of the local residents were registered in the Atlantic instead of their hometown. It's just that the US Census Bureau did not have accurate data on their location and marked the data as missing. If the mistake had not been corrected in time, several thousand law-abiding Wisconsinians would have lost the right to vote. In what is perhaps the most critical geographic information systems have several levels of data validation. But bad code is becoming more common, and questionable management decisions are being made even in areas where bad design costs hundreds of lives. That is why the existence of the Zero Island can still come back to haunt humanity more than once, if you do not take it seriously. Of particular interest to researchers is the dual status of the Zero Island. On the other hand, it is a place that does not exist in reality and has no physical equivalent. On the other hand, it plays a colossal role in various types of human activity and is essentially indispensable in the modern world. Because of this, serious disputes even flare up on whether to put on the cards at all. Mankind knows examples of fictional and intangible objects that have become real. Have you heard of Anglo settlement in New York State? It was invented in the 1930s by the founder of the General Drafting Publishing House, along with his assistant to track illegal copying of the company's cards. And in the 1950s, a store and a couple of houses appeared on the site, forcing the Delaware County authorities to recognize the place. After Harry Potter gained worldwide fame, London Kings received a landmark platform, 9¾. The human desire to give different places additional meaning is truly limitless. If the Zero Island was on land, someone had opened an amusement park or at least a souvenir shop there for a long time. But so far, travel to the sacred point with the coordinates of 0° north latitude and 0° east longitude is rare. Although unusual cruises have already taken place, and more than once in 2019, the Marshall Ustinov missile cruiser visited Zero Island, and in 2001, the Sherman patrol ship of the US Coast Guard. Would you like to be in reality on the Zero Island? Leave a comment. Let's discuss it. Who knows? Maybe we will go on a trip to this point together. Subscribe to the channel and join our community of lovers of science, space, and the unknown using the links in the description to keep abreast of events. Hugs.